Hello guys, it's Aim95 here, back with another video. In today's video, we're going to be trying to get this old Lima, prairie tank. No, this is a prairie. This is a... What is this? 900 glass. Running again. So, yeah. Without further ado, let's get into this. This is another one that I got in a lot with a... Jinty and another locomotive. This one being probably the worst off of the lot. Straight off the bat, we have parts for the other locomotive in the lot, which is something that we will not disclose yet. To repair body fit. Something. Put that aside. We have these, which I believe are steps. It's off somewhere. Right, let's see what we've got here. We have a hose pipe, a screw mount. And the locomotive. Now, this does seem to be mainly a cosmetic repair. Just taking a look at it, the main issue is just that the body needs to be glued back together. And it does not seem to be missing any other parts on the body, really, other than that. And yeah. So, let's take a look at the model. Huh. Alright, so that's interesting. There is no contact with the drivers on the middle wheel here. No wheel is sprung, it's only the two. Drivers, which are actually doing the work. We have a big weight here. Oh, and that seems to be what is holding on the running board. I am not at all familiar with how Lima models work, but I'm guessing below here is the commutator, and it all seems to be fine by the looks of things in there from what I can see. Give some power to the truck. Oh yeah. Alright, so this model seems to be running fine. Don't seem to have any issues mechanically. The big issue seems to be that one blue tack is right there, and two, that the body shell has fallen off. So, seeing as we have a obviously not factory screw here that is coated in blue tack, take that off, move that to the side. This seems to be the major issue that they tried to repair. Keep the shell on with blue tack, and that obviously failed, leading it to sort of present time. So let's get some isopropyl alcohol. Alright, that's about as good as we're going to get that. We're going to put that to the side. Let's take a look at the shell. Okay. So this obviously slides into here. Oh, there's more blue tack. Alright, so that holds up through hole. Alright. So by the looks of things, if we just get this body reattached the best we can, we will be up and running again. So we are going to take some super glue, carefully apply it to the inside of the body, just a very slight bit on the edges. Alrighty. Now I'm going to carefully put the smoke box in. Put pressure like that. Seems to be trick. Let that sit and dry for a second. Put a bit more super glue just right there. Awesome. Alright, so that seems to be perfectly fine. Now we just need to get this handrail back in. So what I'm going to do is situate through the two mounts. Side of smoke box, find the holes. Water tank. Carefully press the mount to the smoke box. And there you go. So that is on and that's looking pretty back to perfect. Trying to see on the inside with my light where. Handrails actually are adult thing. There. Alrighty. Looks pretty good. There's a bit of glue marking on the side of the boiler here. Oh! Ha! That's not good. Can I make that fade away? No, I cannot. Well, this seems to be a painted model. So. I'll just use some water. Get rid of these markings. I'll have to find a good way to repair that paint that I just destroyed right there on the side tank. But other than that, don't seem to really have any other decorating issues. So I think it's fine to just put the running board back on. Thank you. shall. There we go. Now the weight's in. Alright, shell does not seem to go on. Okay. That just happened. Side in, and that side in, and that's our shell mostly back together. We'll just carefully take our chassis. This is not the way this should be done, but I had no real other choice, so it's the way I'm doing it. So we need a different screw for the front because that screw is not long enough. Runs. Feels a bit wobbly. I don't know why. But oh well. Do I have a screw that would work? Alright, so we found an old servo screw which seems to work perfectly. That seems to be it back together. I do want to take a look under the base keeper plate. Let's see how grease and stuff is. The axles are, this is a pretty decently heavy model, but I do foresee that it's probably a plastic. Mainly plastic at least. Jesse, did I forget that screw? I did completely. Oh. Already taking off the base keeper plate to take a look at things before we wrap this up. Oh, yeah. I think the story behind this model, by the given evidence, is that this model was bought, run a couple of times, then broken, and someone tried to repair it. Then gave up with horrible looks, put it in a box somewhere, and then eventually it got sold off to me. So, back on the base keeper plate, everything seems to have very minimal use or signs of use. It's in very good condition. Aside from the new missing patch of paint, that's thanks to me. So there we go. I'm gonna say that is a job well done. It runs. I do think it needs a good This thing will get a lot more lively the more it's run. So yeah, hope y'all enjoyed today's video. Hit the like button and subscribe, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye!